Hey everyone, TJ Hernandez here with RosterCoach.com, and this is the Divisional Round GPP Value Report, where I'll be going through the featured contests on both FanDuel and DraftKings and looking out the prize structures of these contests to help you out with your game selection depending on what you're looking for in your game, whether you're looking for a game with a lot of upside or a game with a flatter, more steady payout. And this week is a little bit different than we saw last week in wild card round, especially on FanDuel. So last week, FanDuel had their main slate on Saturday and Sunday. This week, FanDuel is basically running two main slates, a full Saturday slate and a full Sunday slate. There is a Saturday to Sunday slate, but the bigger prizes are on the Saturday and Sunday games, with Saturday having slightly larger prize pools. So the games on Saturday and Sunday on FanDuel look like they mirror each other in terms of the name and the buy-in of the contest, but the prize pool and the structures do differ a little bit. So I'll go over that again, noting that there's slightly more money in the two-game Saturday slate on FanDuel. And starting with that Saturday slate up to the $10 level, the big main contest is the Saturday playoff special at the $7 buy-in level. That's a $750,000 prize pool with $150,000 going to first place. That first place prize accounts for 20% of the prize pool, but that game is also paying out the highest amount of the field relative to the other games at these lower stakes games. Just under 24% of the field is being paid out in that one. And with smaller prize pools on these divisional rounds, there's only one other contest with a first place prize of at least $10,000 on the Saturday slate below $10, and that's the rush at the $5 level. That's a $150,000 prize pool with $20,000 going to first place. Less than 20% of the field is being paid in that game, and we'll see, unlike some of the weeks in the past, closer to 20% is kind of standard for what we're going to see in the percent of the field paid. Sometimes we've seen anywhere 22 to 25% of the field being paid at the lower stakes. But this week, just not that many contests. The only game that really stands out or comes close to that Saturday playoff special in terms of the size of the field being paid out is the pancake block at the 25-cent level, 23% of the field being paid. But of course, at that 25-cent buy-in, the rake is 16.5%. So a really steep rake there despite the flatter payout structure. Of course, the game that kind of combines good value with a decently sized player pool is the Huddle at the $3 level. No experienced players allowed in that contest, so you're not going to face any sharks in that game. Just a 10% rake, and 22% of the field is paid, while under 9% of the money is going to first place. So a chance to turn $3 into $3,000 in a pretty good contest there. Other than that, none of these games really stand out in terms of upside or really flat payout structure. Again, just the ones I mentioned. The Spike is a single entry game paying out about 22% of the field, where you could turn $5 into $4,000, but just not a lot of big prizes to be had, at least at the smaller stakes on Saturday. If we move up beyond the $10 level, the couple big games that stand out are the Divisional Showdown at the $250 level. That game is paying out $50,000 to first place in a $250,000 prize pool. So we see about 22% of the field being paid. Again, kind of an anomaly in that these bigger contests actually have a better payout structure than some of these smaller contests, at least in terms of percent of the field being paid. We actually only see one other contest paying out a higher percentage of the field than that Divisional Showdown. The other game with a big first place prize is the Bomb at the $33 level. The structure of that game has remained pretty much the same throughout the year. So this week it's a $200,000 prize pool with $50,000 going to first place. That is about 25% of the prize pool, just over 20% of the field being paid in that one. And then relatively small prize pools throughout at these other contests. I mentioned one other game besides the divisional showdown paying out a higher percentage of the field, and that's the kickoff at the $12 level. A chance to turn $12 into $5,000. That $5,000 accounts for 11% of the $45,000 prize pool, which is the smallest amount of money going to first place of any game priced above $10. So something to take note of there. A couple interesting notes, the hot route at the $50 level and the cover two at the $100 level, two single entry games, not paying out a huge percent of the field. In fact, pretty small percentage of the field, just 19%. But on a min cash, you do 2.5x your money. So that's something that I'm always looking to take into account. And you do get a bit of a rake reduction compared to games priced $35 and below, about 12% rake on those games. So even though not a huge percentage of the field being paid, those games do offer pretty decent value. Moving over to the main Sunday slate on FanDuel, as I mentioned, the games kind of look the same and the structures are similar, but they don't perfectly mirror each other. So looking at the smaller stakes games, the $750,000 Sunday playoff special is still paying out $150,000 to first place on Sunday. That's the only contest, the big contest that remains static. If we look at the Rush with a $12,000 first place prize, $125,000 prize pool, so a little bit smaller than the one we see on Saturday. And again, that pancake block is paying out a large percentage of the field, about 24%, but the money's way more spread out on the Sunday pancake block than it is on the Saturday contest. Just $400 first place prize on Sunday. That money's really spread out. We just see less than 2% of the money going to first place there. And at the higher stakes, where that divisional showdown is a $250,000 prize pool on Saturday, the prize pool is down to $200,000 on Sunday, but still paying out $50,000 to first place. So 25% of the money is going to first place in that one. The Bomb, again, a little bit smaller prize pool, smaller first place prize compared to Saturday. $175,000 prize pool in the Bomb with $30,000 going to first place. And unlike Saturday, on Sunday, the game paying out the highest percentage of the field is the Sweat at the $750 level. That game is just 29 entries with 8 people being paid out, but those 8 people do account for almost 28% of the field. And then the Hot Route is paying 2.5x on a min cash, which is the $50 single entry game there. The $100 game, the cover two, a little different structure, not a 2.5x there, but there is $10,000 up top on the Sunday game. So quite a bit of variance between the games on Saturday and Sunday, again, which FanDuel is kind of splitting up their main slate this week. Moving on over to DraftKings. DraftKings is running a pretty normal slate, at least for the playoffs, a two-day slate, Saturday to Sunday, full slate, a few less games than we've seen in the past, but some decent prizes to be had. At the lower stakes that we're looking at here, up to the $12 buy-in level, the only game offering a really big upside is the Divisional Final Four at the $4 level. That's a $1 million prize pool with $50,000 going to first place. No other contest priced at $12 or below has a first place prize above $7,500. So the post pattern at the $8 level has a $7,500 first place prize, and the fair catch at the $12 level has a $5,000 first place prize. The fair catch actually paying out one of the highest percentages of the field of any contest, about 27%. We see all of these games at the lower stakes paying out about 25% of the field. 27 is pretty high, 24 is really low, but a pretty small deviation in the structure of these games outside of the rake. And as we'll see when we move up to the higher stakes on DraftKings, a little more variance between the structures of these games. And finally, looking at those higher stakes games on DraftKings, the Quarter Millionaire, similar to the contest they ran last week where $250,000 is going to first place, but this week the prize pool is just $1,750,000 compared to $2 million last week, and the buy-in moved up $5, so $25 buy-in on the Quarter Millionaire this week. if anybody wants to play higher stakes games and still looking for some decent upside, you're going to have to move up quite a bit in stakes from the millionaire. Up at the $150 level, we have the Power Sweep, which is offering $50,000 to first place, but that game's paying out less than 21% of the field. That's the lowest we see of any contest on the entire main slate. And then the Wildcat is the same structure as last week at the $333 buy-in level, $700,000 prize pool. We still see $100,000 up top, but still a pretty small percentage of the field being paid in that one, just 22%. The one game that stands out at these higher stakes is the checkdown pass, the $777 buy-in game, just 35 entries in that one, but 29% of the field is being paid there, and you do get a really nice rake drop if you're playing those really high stakes, just 8% rake on that game. Only other two contests paying out more than 25%. We have the goal line at the $75 level, paying out 27% of the field. The juke at the $400 level, which is a two max game, paying out about 26% of the field. So not a ton of upside in those games, but pretty flat payout structures, large percentage of the field being paid compared to these higher stakes games. So that's what we're looking at for the divisional round. Of course, if you have any questions, hit me up here or on Twitter. Again, TJ Hernandez with RosterCoach.com. Thank you for watching.